My topic is bronchoscopy in COVID ICU. Now, all guidelines suggest bronchoscopy is relatively contraindicated in COVID-19, or it should play a limited role in diagnosis and management. Elective bronchoscopy should be avoided for at least 28 days from onset of infection. But still, there are certain situations where you need bronchoscopy in ICU. Now, it is different than the bronchoscopy in ward or bronchoscopic suite because patients may be unstable hemodynamically and may have one or more unstable organ system. So high-risk patients for the procedure. Critical care issues are different, like time available is very short, always there is an urgency. ICU are more crowded with other monitoring and therapeutic equipment, so little space for the bronchoscopist, and certain ancillary devices like fluoroscopy is not available. There are more chances of iatrogenic hypoxemia and respiratory failure in critically ill patient. Now, bronchoscopy is one of the highest risk procedures in COVID patients because of aerosol generation and disruption of airway mucosa. There are chances of infection to the medical personnel due to close contact with the patient. Coughing and suction can produce significant amounts of droplets or aerosols, which is contaminating equipment, procedure room, and all personnel present, and even there is higher risk of patient-to-patient cross-infection. What are the therapeutic indications of bronchoscopy? Airway management, when there is difficult intubation, that is, anesthetist has tried for 10 minutes or more than 3 trials he has done, then the intubation, endotracheal intubation can be done through bronchoscope and nasal intubation is preferred. You can visualize the distal end of endotracheal tube. You can change or replace the endotracheal tube if the tube is blocked or you want to replace to be the higher number. Placement of the double lumen tube in case of the hemoptysis and monitoring of laryngotracheal injury caused by long-lasting endotracheal tube. Guiding percutaneous dilation tracheostomy to avoid injury to the posterior wall. So in this situation of the airway management, bronchoscope can help. Now, emergency intubation should be avoided as far as possible. Awake intubation should also be avoided, and nebulizers for local anesthesia should be avoided as this may aerosolize the virus. Staff should be limited to those essential for the procedure in order to reduce the exposure. Now, most experienced operators should perform the procedure and limit bagging during the pre-oxygenation phase and again after the endotracheal tube is placed. Now, placement confirmation should be done by ETCO2 and observation of the equal chest movements. Auscultation should not be performed and chest access should be avoided if possible. Now, in case of massive hemoptysis, you need bronchoscopic to instill chilled normal saline or adrenaline or hemostatics locally. And for placement of the double lumen endotracheal tube or Fogarty balloon catheter, you need FOB. Endotracheal, endobronchial electrocautery or laser therapy or cryocautery in case of the massive hemoptysis can be done through FOB. And also the FOB can localize the site of bleeding before bronchial artery embolization. Now, this is very common indications of fibrotic bronchoscopy in ICU. There are aspiration of mucus plugs and secretions causing volume loss and atelectasis and hypoxemia is an indication for urgent FOB in these cases. When these cases are refractory to the vigorous chest physiotherapy and suctioning. Now, this is especially true in occasional mucus impaction in some COVID-19 patients. Also, it may identify bronchial migration of endotracheal tube as a cause of collapse. Now, sometimes there may be gastric aspiration, and aspiration of the food, even if the pH is more than 2.5, can cause significant pulmonary damage. And with FOB, thick food material can be removed by washing and aspiration. Now, if there is foreign body, then it becomes an urgent indication for FOB. And this foreign body can be removed through bronchoscope using Dorbium baskets or rigid bronchoscope. Now, what are the diagnostic indications of bronchoscopy? Bronchoscopy in COVID patients should only be considered if the nasopharyngeal smear is negative 2 times and clinically there is still diagnostic uncertainty of COVID-19 infection or other diagnoses are considered that would significantly change clinical management. Associated bacterial, viral, and fungal co-infection can be easily identified by direct sampling as well as the mycology and galactomannan in these samples in these patients by FOB. Now, ventilator-associated pneumonia occurs in more than 30% of the patients, and accurate sampling can reduce unnecessary antibiotics. Now, in immunocompromised patients who are not responding to empirical antibiotics and are test negative for the COVID-19 and have no other diagnostic means available, then urgent bronchoscopy within 1 to 2 days may be warranted. Now, if the bronchoscopy is performed for diagnostic reason, the BAL only is recommended, and other procedures like transbronchial biopsy or needle aspiration should not be performed in the same time. In cases of suspected lung cancer, bronchoscopy should be performed if delayed diagnosis can cause poor outcome of the cancer, and also if the tumor is responsible causing lobar collapse. Now, how you do bronchoscopy in ICU? The bronchoscopic should have direct observation of the monitor. You should be monitoring all the equipments. In non-intubated patients, it can transnasal route is preferred with additional use of slotted mouth and nose protector for the patient. If the patient is intubated but not on mechanical ventilation, then FOB can be done through endotracheal tube or tracheostomy tube. If the patient is intubated and on CPAP or SIV, then you can discontinue mechanical ventilation for a short time. And if the patient is on mandatory ventilation, then T-tube connection or C-well three-way adapter is required. Now, only essential personnel should participate in this high-risk procedure, and visitors and students should not be allowed to be present in ICU. Now, staff should wear the full protection, and they should wear the PPE, and general anesthesia with muscle relaxant is recommended in COVID-19 patients to reduce aerosol production, and enough should be tried to reduce the cough as far as possible in these patients by under general anesthesia or by giving dexmedetomidine or other cough suppressants. Now, one should avoid devices that produce aerosol, including nebulizers or atomizers and high flow nasal oxygen during bronchoscopy. And open tube rigid bronchoscopy and jet ventilation should be avoided, and also avoid repeatedly removing and reintroducing the bronchoscope. Now, certain adjustment has to be done on if the patient is in ICU. Like endotracheal tube should be at least 8 mm for adult fiber optic bronchoscopy, which is having outer diameter of 5.6 mm. Increase FiO to 100% 15 minutes before, during, and 1 hour post FOB. Now, consider increasing tidal volume or inspiratory pressure by 20%. Discontinue PEEP or maintain below 8 cm. Also monitor exhaled tidal volume and airway pressure. Monitor SpO2, monitor hemodynamics, and monitor ECG. Now, if the patient is on veno-venous ECMO support, anticoagulation should have been stopped a few hours before the procedure, and clotting time should be tested before the procedure. Platelet should be at least more than 50,000, and BAL may be performed in these cases. M1 FOB can be done if the patient is NIV and hypoxic patient is there in ICU. Then it can safely undergo bedside diagnostic and simple therapeutic bronchoscopy with NIV support with low complications rate. Now, this is a disposable, one-time use, single-use bronchoscope, and which is new possibility, which eliminates the need for complex clinical procedures and minimize the risk of cross-contamination. With this bronchoscope, the patient can be treated immediately when needed without having to wait for the arrival of a reusable scope and stacking system. Its working channel of 2.8 millimeter makes it highly suitable for management of tufts, retained secretions, and BAL procedure. So this scope, which is a single-use scope, is used difficult to find and is not present in everywhere. So BAL is the procedure which is commonly performed with the fiber optic bronchoscopy to retrieve the samples. Now, it is originally referred to as a liquid lung biopsy, and it samples contents of the millions of alveoli. So the yield is therefore greatest for the alveolar filling procedure. Now, if a patient is in ICU and you take an X-ray and you find new shadows appearing, always these new shadows are not infectious or pneumonia. There can be drug-induced pneumonitis, there can be aspiration of gastric contents, it can be pulmonary emboli, it can be ARDS, it can be lung contusion, it can be cardiogenic pulmonary edema, or lymphangitis carcinomatosis, or it can be atelectasis. So BAL samples will differentiate the infectious lesions with the non-infectious lesion. In COVID, BAL have sensitivity up to 93% compared to 72% in sputum and 63% in nasal swabs in these patients. Now, in ICU patients, if the BAL is done, Then IL-8 and IL-6 levels are increased, giving the early diagnosis. And determination of the cytokine concentration in lavage blood may be useful for evaluation of severity and course of the ARDS patients. Level of D dimers are also markedly elevated in ARDS as measured by in ball. Now, protected dismission brush is another procedure which can be performed in these patients through FOP, and it procures uncontaminated lower respiratory secretions. More than 10:3 colony forming unit per ml on culture is indication of an infection. Now, sensitivity is up to 66%, and the test is specific in up to 90% of the cases. Now, bronchoscopes are listed as semi-critical devices as they do not enter the vascular system, so as other critical devices do. However, a high level of the disinfection process should be used, and post-procedure sterilization include leak testing, visual inspection, followed by sterilization. Now, specimens should be stored and processed according to the biosafety requirements. All staff must remove personal protective equipment according to the appropriate training and leave the examination area only after ensuring strict hand hygiene. Now, what are the effects of FOB? Now, up to 20 centimeters of the water PEEP increases if the endotracheal tube is of 8 millimeter size with adult bronchoscope, and it increases up to 30 centimeters of the water if the endotracheal size tube of size is 7 millimeter. Now, it increases the FRC by 30%, FEV1 decreased by 40%, it reduces the vital capacity, and it significantly reduces the exhaled tidal volume. Hypoxemia is also common up to 2 hours post-procedure, and PO2 drops by 20 to 30 millimeter the mercury in uncomplicated procedure, but it can go up to 30 to 60 millimeter drop in critically ill patients. Suction can further induce 40% fall in the partial pressure of the oxygen, and suction should be applied for short periods like 3 seconds or less at a time. Now, hypercapnia up to 8 millimeter of the mercury is common in an uncomplicated procedure. There can be increase in the mean arterial pressure, increased heart rate, increase in pulmonary artery pressure, and decrease in the cardiac output up to 50% of the patients. But these all hemodynamic effects returns to the baseline within 15 minutes after the procedure. Now, the complications of FOB are most important is infection to the healthcare workers in COVID bronchoscopy, and decreased inhalation pressure, FOB induced pneumothorax, hypotension, cardiac arrhythmias, bronchospasm, FOB induced secondary infection, fever due to release of inflammatory mediators, and lidocaine toxicity. Now, the absolute contraindication is bronchoscopy is if inexperienced or team is inexperienced, then bronchoscopy should not be performed. If there are absence of suitable facilities or equipment for protection, then bronchoscopy should not be performed. And if there is inability to maintain proper oxygenation during the procedure should not be performed. Relative contraindication includes severe hypoxemia, acute coronary syndrome, uncontrolled arrhythmias, uncontrolled bronchospasm, auto PEEP more than 15 centimeters, bleeding diastasis, severe pulmonary artery hypertension, increased intracranial tension, and chronic renal failure, pulmonary abscess. So all these are relative contraindication. Thank you very much.